How does the organizational pattern of the opening paragraph in Mrs. Manstey's view contribute to the overall meaning of the text? In this lesson, you will learn how an author's stylistic choices contribute to the meaning of the text by analyzing text structure. But let's review. We've been doing a close reading of Mrs. Manstey's View by Edith Wharton. In previous lessons, we've discussed characterization, point of view, figurative language, tone, and theme. All of these elements play an important role in the overall meaning of the story. In this lesson, we are focusing on text structure. Knowing the elements of text structure is an effective tool in understanding both fiction and nonfiction, because as authors write to communicate an idea, they will use a text structure that goes along with that idea. Remember, the text structure refers to how information is organized in a passage. One type of text structure is pattern of organization. There are 7 common patterns used in writing. One pattern is cause and effect. With this type of writing, the cause is typically discussed first, then the effects are discussed. Another pattern of organization is compare and contrast. An author will use this to show the similarities and differences between two items or ideas. Chronological order is another pattern. This is when a story is told in the same order the events occur. With spatial or descriptive writing, the author takes the readers from one spot to the next, as if the reader is physically looking at something. Another pattern of organization is order of importance. Here, the writer prioritizes the ideas according to a hierarchy of value. Information can be structured from most important to least important, or vice versa. Process writing instructs the reader to do something in a specific order. It's basically a set of directions or a manual. And finally, a writer may choose to use the problem-solution pattern. Here, the problem is typically described first, followed by a suggested solution with details that support the solution. An important thing to understand about the patterns of organization is that an author may use a variety of patterns throughout the text, or he or she may choose to write the entire piece with one pattern. In order to identify the organizational pattern, however, you have to do a close reading of the entire text. So when we are trying to identify the text structure and how it contributes to the meaning of the overall text, we're going to follow these 3 steps. First, we will reread a paragraph and identify how it is organized. Then, we will highlight the words and phrases that help develop the plot. And third, we will ask ourselves, how does this organizational pattern impact the plot and create meaning in the text? We're going to be doing a close reading of page 1. We're going to be looking at the first paragraph in the text. So the first thing we need to do is reread the passage and determine the organizational pattern. At this point, I want you to pause the lesson and reread the passage on your own. When you are done, come back and resume the lesson. Now, if I had not reread the passage, I would have said the organizational pattern was descriptive because so many of the paragraphs describe what Mrs. Manstey sees. But now that I've reread the passage, I am seeing a different structure. I see 3 different parts to this paragraph. In the first section, it does exactly what we're used to seeing, a description of the setting, describes where she lives and what the landscape looks like. In the next section, it addresses Mrs. Manstey's relationship with her daughter. This is actually the majority of the paragraph. Then in the last section, it talks about Mrs. Manstey's acceptance of her situation. So whereas Wharton does use a lot of descriptive writing in this text, I think this first paragraph is organized by the order of importance, least important to most important. Wharton wants her readers to notice that Mrs. Manstey's view is an important part of the story, but she spends the majority of the paragraphs on Mrs. Manstey's relationship with her daughter. I think Wharton does this to emphasize the importance of the lack of human connection in Mrs. Manstey's life. And finally, I think Wharton moves from the mother-daughter relationship into the fact that Mrs. Manstey is okay with this solitary lifestyle so that the reader doesn't feel sorry about her choice to be alone. Now, the next thing we need to do is highlight the words and phrases that help develop the plot. For this step, we're going to look at each of the 3 parts separately. The view from Mrs. Manstey's window was not a striking one, and Mrs. Manstey occupied the back room on the 3rd floor of a New York boarding house. Both of these identify the setting. By identifying where Mrs. Manstey lives, Wharton is immediately identifying her as part of the lower class. We know that this plays a big part in the plot because Mrs. Manstey and Mrs. Black are in different social classes and cannot understand each other's point of view. That is what causes all of the tension in the story. Now, in the next section, Widow stands out, and so does ceased to feel any need of each other's society, and their intercourse had long been limited to the exchange of a few perfunctory letters. Now, a widow is a woman whose husband has died and she has not remarried, so this immediately tells the reader that she is alone. This detail helps develop the plot because it adds to Miss Manstey's characterization. Then the next part talks about Mrs. Manstey's relationship with her daughter. The word perfunctory means superficial, so this tells me that the letters between Mrs. Manstey and her daughter had no true substance or emotion to them. What this tells me about the plot is that if Mrs. Manstey cannot even have a connection with her own family, how in the world can she be expected to connect with a stranger like Mrs. Black? So it sets up the communication struggle that is about to ensue with Mrs. Manstey and Mrs. Black. So, just in the first two parts of the introductory paragraph, we have been given insight into the setting, characterization, and communication issues that Wharton is about to explore further in the plot. Now, in this last section, the end stands out to me. Accepted as a matter of course her solitary life in New York. This tells us that Mrs. Manstey accepts her situation. So Mrs. Manstey is okay with living alone. How does this help develop the plot? Well, I think it directly sets the reader up for the theme of one person cannot make a difference. Wharton starts the story telling the reader that Mrs. Manstey is all by herself with no allies. Then at the end of the story, she is still alone in her failed endeavor to stop the construction, thus bringing out the theme that one person cannot make a difference. Now that we have highlighted the words and phrases that help develop the plot, we can now ask ourselves, how does this organizational pattern impact the plot and create meaning in the text? Remember, we have three parts to the paragraph: the setting, the mother-daughter relationship, and the acceptance of her solitary lifestyle. By using order of importance as the organizational pattern of the opening paragraph, Wharton is moving from the external into the internal. Yes, the external view from Mrs. Manstey's window is important to the plot, but it's not the most important part of the story. The most important parts of the story deal with who Mrs. Manstey is, because in finding out who she really is, we can justify her actions in the end. Remember, this story is told using the third-person limited point of view. The narrator only knows the thoughts and feelings of one character. With this point of view, the reader has to be invested in the character. We feel Mrs. Manstey's desperation to save her view, and we understand her reasons for setting fire to the balcony. If Wharton did not spend the majority of the story revealing the real Mrs. Manstey to us, then we would have never been able to justify her actions in the end. Now, let's go back to our text-dependent question. How does the organizational pattern of the opening paragraph in Mrs. Manstey's view contribute to the overall meaning of the text? Well, the opening paragraph of Mrs. Manstey's view is written in order of importance, from least important to most important. This text structure supports the overall meaning of the text by placing emphasis on the character rather than the setting. So looking at the text structure is very important. It helps the reader focus on the important elements of the story. And when we are trying to identify how the organizational pattern impacts the overall meaning of the text, we can follow these three steps. First, reread a paragraph and identify how it is organized. Then, highlight the words and phrases that help develop the plot. And third, ask, how does the organizational pattern impact the plot and create meaning in the text? In this lesson, you have learned how an author's stylistic choices contribute to the meaning of the text by analyzing text structure.